welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you for letting us be a part of your day. And you know, there are lots of good things happening, and you can still feel the hand of God in this crazy world we find ourselves in. And we're going to have some positive things to share with you today. First of all, we're going to talk about the Heroes 5K Run, which is coming up on the 1st of February at Furman. We can all be there. And then we also have guests from Pendleton Place for Children and Families. And I want to share, as we begin, some thoughts with you very quickly. You know, anybody who knows me knows I love a sale. And whenever I go to a bookstore, I always look and see. And sometimes there are tables with books piled up. And I was blessed this year to go to London in December, which is my favorite place in the world. And I went to a bookstore, Waterstones, which is one of my favorite bookstores. And there was this table piled with books and a big sale sign. And I found this little book, and I want to share a quote with you because it had great meaning for me. During World War II, at the very beginning of the war, really, 1939, there was an English lady who wrote poetry, and her name was Minnie Louise Haskins. And here's what the ending of her poem. "And I said to the man who stood at the gate of the year, give me a light that I may tread safely into the unknown. And he replied, go out into the darkness and put your hand into the hand of God. That shall be to you better than light and safer than a known way." And as we are here today in the beginning of a new year, I wanted to share that with you. It's amazing what you can find on a sale table. And now I want to introduce a lovely friend, and I'm so glad she's here, Debbie Whitsett. And Debbie is here because she's having this race. And how many years has this gone on now?
This will be the fourth annual 5K.
This is the Heroes 5K in honor of your son who perished in Afghanistan and all other military as well.
Yes, it is. It's in memory of Jeffrey and all of our soldiers or service people who have died for our nation in whatever manner that was.
All right, and it's at Furman University.
Yes.
On Saturday, February the 1st, and you want everybody, there's gonna be coffee and hot chocolate and things for children, and yes, you don't have to run. Now, maybe you're a runner and you really wanna get in, but you don't have to.
No, you can walk, you can come in a wheelchair. We have a lady that is on crutches who has finished the race each year. We need cheerleaders. We need people just standing, holding the American flag.
Okay. So
anybody and everybody.
Take your grandchildren.
Oh, yes.
Take your children and participate.
Mm-hmm. And it's very patriotic.
Now, is it, how much does it cost? I mean, you are gathering funds.
We are gathering.
What? Tell us what that's about.
Okay. People can go to the website, aheroes5k.com. There is a registration tab. Right now, it's $25 to register. There's also a section where you can, I think it's register from afar. So anywhere in the world, people can register. That's $35 because then they will be assured a t-shirt, okay, and a Heroes 5K, okay, will mail it to them.
But if somebody just wants to come and observe and see what this is all about, that's okay too.
Absolutely.
Isn't it?
We want everybody to show up.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
But if you want to walk or run, there is a contribution you can make.
Yes.
And that money goes to what?
This year it's being divided between Upstate Warrior Solution.
Upstate Warriors Solution.
Yes.
Okay.
And also the Patriot Rovers. Patriot Rovers is just over in North Carolina, but they are training a service dog to be given to an upstate veteran. And half of our proceeds are going to go to Patriot
That's
Rovers.
Wonderful. And these dogs are very valuable. It takes a long time to train these animals. So when you get one that is trained, and they are used for what? I mean, they're given to a special person.
Yes. That dog is going to be given to an upstate soldier who will be chosen out of a list of people who have applied. And every one of these dogs from Patriot Rovers is given a name by a Gold Star family.
Okay.
And so it's the dogs are not only going to be given, but they are attached in name to a soldier's family.
Who's perished. All right. Now, so these dogs are trained so that if a person is handicapped or have vision problems or whatever, the dog steps in as a helpmate.
These dogs are mainly support dogs for soldiers who have post-traumatic stress disorder and traumatic brain injury.
So they're there to help in any way.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So I wanted everybody to know about this. Mm-hmm. Heroes 5K1, put it on your calendar. Come rain or shine. And there's good parking at Furman.
Very good parking.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the event takes place in front of Timmins Arena.
All right.
And the only reason for a Heroes 5K to be canceled is if the weather is really bad.
Like ice or something.
Ice. Yeah. We don't want to put anybody's life in jeopardy.
Otherwise, even if it's raining.
Yeah.
Just
go. Yes.
I'm going to be there.
Good.
Okay.
I want you to be there.
Debbie Whitsett, we appreciate all that you are doing to make this a better world.
Thank you.
God bless you. We're going to go to a quick break, and we're going to come back, and we're going to find out about Pendleton Place for children and families.